And there's award-winning short film in the title, so that's promising. Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah. And this is what I call freaking smart editing.
Hi, I'm Martin Caroy, filmmaker. I decided as a kid that I want to make movies. To make people laugh, think. Creating a positive impact. I worked in the film industry.
I'll be back.
Then I started my business to create my films.
We ride, freedom.
If you search me on Google, nothing happens. Yet.
I published the first video in the Reacting to Your Films series, and before publishing, I had 4 film submissions. However, after publishing, the number of the submissions went up. When I saw the numbers growing, I was like, yes, come on. So currently we have 23 film submissions. So let's react to them. Very nice opening shot and title design. Nice. Clever transition there. Again, nice. A lot of times you will see this type of a match cut and it's so forced. If you want to do a transition like that, it's not just about editing it by forcing 2 clips to kind of work together. Sometimes you can be lucky and 2 clips just magically, randomly work together. But I would suggest actually filming those shots with this purpose in mind. So many different kind of shots put together in a nice sequence. Yeah, kind of works. Maybe I'm too picky, but for me to put this transition here, I will need not just the same kind of camera movement, which is the tilting, matching the tilting, but also the direction of the tilting. Because the first shot was tilting down, so I will need an up tilt to match it. But the reason why I'm saying this is because, in my opinion, this is the next level how you can do these kind of transitions. This hyperlapse is nice. It wasn't just cool to watch, but it also transitioned you from the inner city to a different kind of environment. Nice. All right, that was freaking clever. Such a fine detail, and just by utilizing sound design. So you see this culture happening, you hear the horn, and you hear the horn again, and after that the guy actually looks up, and because of the editing you think because of the horn sound, and also the birds, very nice. Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah. I'm so struggling to find bird flying away sound effect. So if you know one, please send it to me. That is a brilliant shot right there. That is a brilliant shot. Change of tempo, change of mood. Now we're going to the climax. How good it was not just to see the tension, but also hearing it by making the talking hearable. Very nice. And we get another sound which makes the rhythm change again. And it's also a great choice to show this shot, which is from inside a building, probably the church, and just peeping through that middle section. Yeah, like I said, change of tempo, change of rhythm, just with that one sound. It's a good transition. To my taste, there are too many cuts in this sequence. Just imagine seeing this action just from this angle for like a 10-second long take. I think that would have been better. Nice fine detail with sound. So you can see the wind with these particles right there, and you can also hear it. I'm actually surprised this is the first time we hear wind. There were a lot of shots where, as the editor, you could have made the decision, but the creator held on to this moment, and I'm digging it. At first I was like, oh no, no, I don't really like that transition. But after seeing another transition and then another one, then I changed my mind. Then I really changed my mind. And the guitar is done. Now the machine sleeps. And the worker too. Well, this creation is awesome. I liked it so, so much. So this short film is one big journey. But how is it one journey? With the magic of smart, purposeful editing. Because the story you watched here is not actually in the footage. Martin put together this story. I think it was really clever how there were different storylines introduced to us. And then we see the progression in each of the storyline. And these storylines are matching in mood, are matching in rhythm. See how the tension builds up in each of the storylines. We got the religious happening, we got nature with the time lapse, we got the guitar making. So that was just one example how Martin could match the mood, match the rhythm, and metaphorically connect different storylines. And this is what I call freaking smart editing. Again, another example, they go up to see the sun. The sun is setting. And then we got this fake one take. Different guitar shops, and then the final one with a customer and a finished guitar. Now, do you remember how the short film started? So the preparation of tools in the market, but shortly we will see the guitar shop. They're making the guitar, so the guitar's journey is beginning. If I were a teacher, I would definitely show this short film and break it down to every single detail, because you can see, hear, and feel the purpose of the editing. So Martin, thank you for sharing your work. Your shooting and editing skills are mad, so keep on creating, brother. I would definitely consider bringing you to one of my future trips. So let's like the video and subscribe. Definitely subscribe. 92 views? Come on guys, let's crank this number up. That's a very nice opening shot, let me tell you that. I like this composition. I like that frame. Obviously, we got the tools there. And we got presumably a dead body there. And obviously, somebody is chopping up bodies in the background. This opening sequence set the mood, the atmosphere nicely, and also we have a premise of what the story could be like. At this point, I'm curious about if the story will be more innovative, more unique than the usual horror cliches. Oh shit. This was a nice reaching for the knife sequence. A lot of times in indie films, or actually in Hollywood films as well, as the viewer you can see a scene like that and you could be like, what? He could easily reach that. That's bullshit. no, 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 no. If you use cigarette in your film, in my opinion, you have two options. One, use the original, straight out of the box, perfect cigarette. Two, use rolled cigarettes. In this case, it's not a rolled cigarette. It has a nice curvature like that, which makes me think about impotence adverts on the side of the tobacco packaging. Where's my knife? Do you have my knife, boy? One other thing which I really liked was the sound design so far, especially how they translated this atmosphere, this room, into sounds, into music.
You're awake. I've given you a shot. Not enough to make you fall asleep, but enough to make you be able to observe everything. You see, I need something from you. I need something that you have.
So I think a guy like that wouldn't smash that knife, but do that precisely. Or maybe he's not that precise killer.
We'll be done for here for now.
Sorry, man, gotta go. My pizza is here.
You're gonna like this.
It can actually be a pizza.
Good. It's a recipe that my mother used to make. Her cookies always miss something. Something that had spunk, something that had little bit more taste to it.
That's actually a really good fake blood.
A little special recipe.
Nice. Okay, this is exactly the time where you do a cutaway.
Go get the food, bro. For us, bro. Yo. Yeah, just like, you know, some FIFA, you know,
Okay, this phone conversation is not great. It's actually bad. I get it, it's supposed to be like a very stone, hey, bruh, come on, bruh, go here, bruh. But it's not authentic at all. So my problem with this is the story. I mean, it's not that bad, it's just not good either. It's just general story. Like I said in the beginning, flashback, the story will be more innovative, more unique, and sadly I'm not satisfied story-wise. Apart from that, there were a lot of aspects about the short film that were good, and some were even great. I would just suggest to write a better story. Let's see what they said about this project. I believe this piece of work is a great presentation of what is actually possible to achieve not having Hollywood cameras equipment, but only the idea and passion. Most of the push were made on visuals as we tried to keep story as simple as possible. I agree with him because this short film is actually more like a technical showcase of what indie filmmaking can do even for zero or low budget. Alright, let's like the video and let's subscribe. And you should too, if you like this short film. All right, let's do the next one. All right, so we got a different kind of YouTube link here, which is actually the short film's title. And there's award-winning short film in the title, so that's promising. I already have a feeling that the sound design will be good in this one too. Very, very, very nice visuals. These shots were beautiful, but in an interesting way. I don't like the stars, though.
One to the Haven. Sector 23 is clear. Over.
This is the bridge.
Is it CGI or live action?
We'll head over to Sector 24.
Live action.
Port back when arrived. Over and out.
Roger that. Thank you, Angel One.
But this shot is not that visually pleasing.
Angel 3, do you copy?
This is cool though. The cockpit.
Angel
like
3.
It.
Angel 3, where are you?
Angel 3! What the hell, man?
Honestly, that shot looked terrible.
3! What the hell, man?
It looks like it was animated, just keyframing 2D images, and very poorly, in my opinion.
Oh man, I wish I could see the look on your face. Sorry, I couldn't help myself.
Curious if the cockpit is real or it's CGI. And if this is CGI as well, I mean the live action inserted into a CGI environment, then why the hell do the other CGI shots look terrible?
I'm actually just surprised you didn't look me up on your radar.
Angel 3, you're not showing up on my radar. Over.
Hmm.
That's strange.
What does your computer say?
Yep.
Computer, run a full diagnostic on the ship.
Running full diagnostics. It appears that your radar and long-range communications are malfunctioning.
Computer, what's the source of this malfunction?
Something is intentionally disrupting the signal.
Intentionally disrupting?
Whoa. Angel 1, you seeing this?
Outlier battle cruiser, dead ahead. Prepare to engage!
Multiple fighters, header!
I'm not trying to be a jerk, it just looks funny, because it looks so fake.
Engage! Engage!
Weapons hot. I got a bogey on my tail. I can't shake him.
Pull up Angel 3! Pull up!
Angel 3 is down.
Damn it!
I liked how they didn't show the explosion itself, just the reflection of it on the main character and also in a long take, so we could see his reaction nicely.
Computer, what's the probability of me making it through this?
There is a 0.09% probability for you to live.
I can't say I like those odds.
I'm rooting for this guy. I really am.
There's only one way this ends.
Yeah, we got the family photo right there.
Shields at 20%.
Like the music?
System.
I love you, Lucy. I love you, Lucy.
Game over.
Okay, all right. You got me. I mean, sometimes I was thinking about how the visuals look kind of like an old school 3D game engine. And this is why, because it's an old school arcade game. At this point, I will take back my notes about the CGI, because in the end, it actually makes sense why it looks terrible.
What the heck was that, bro?
I'm a damn war hero.
Yeah.
So this is how you can easily see if it's an indie film or not. Just by looking at the credits, Kevin Borger is in at least 5 different roles. If he's listed 5 times, he probably had like 10. Now let's see what did he write about this project. I think for a short film that was made for $100 in a room, it's actually pretty impressive, and considering it was my first go at a short film. I agree with you mainly because of the gas clouds. If you did actually record those gas clouds...
I would swirl it with my finger, pull my finger
Finger
back.
Technique.
Swirling it with my finger would initiate movement.
So yeah, it's quite impressive what you guys could do with practical effects in this short film. So Kevin, if I can be totally honest with you, after watching the opening sequence, I imagined a different kind of short film. But maybe that was your intention. I would point out one thing about the story. If you, after watching this, are like, okay, yeah, that's a surprising ending, but I've seen this before and it's still too basic for me, then I would say there's a little bit more dimension to it, in my opinion. So because of the main character, this short film is not just about illusion, not just about having a surprising ending and that's it, but it's a story about the idea of heroism, about a man who wants a heroic death, who's captured by the idea of sacrificing himself.
I love you, Lucy.
Lucy! And let's go ahead and like the video and subscribe. You know the drill. So that's it for today. Thank you very much for your film submissions. And please, if you want to submit, the link is in the description. I can't wait to see your creations.